Well, if this isn't vindication in many respects of what I was saying just a couple of weeks ago, essentially, what we now have is yet another major security threat being levied against smartphones and smart devices. And once again, because of the fragmented way that Google's ecosystem works, and the fact that Google has not solved the problem of how to provide security updates to all their devices, Apple will have their update out next week, which will go out to every single iPhone and iPad device, and Google has just released the update to manufacturers who will probably never bother including it. As I said at the time, Google has now got to sort this house out. At the end of the day, because of the way they built the Android operating system, released it to everybody, and failed to provide a back channel there for security updates, we now have over a billion devices with a big security hole. There's a slow clap for you, Google. At the end of the day, these problems, as I said several months ago, were not going to suddenly go away. Because of the way Android is built, we are only going to have more and more and more of these situations. Essentially, Google, for Android 5.5, Android 6, whatever, it has got to come up with a back channel. It has to find a way to stop continuously leaving Android devices with no appreciable way to get security updates. So, what's this latest security threat all about? Well, it's being called the Freak Attack. Now, what has basically happened here is a policy of the US government over a decade ago was to not allow strong forms of encryption to leave the US. That basically meant that devices were being shipped all around the world with weakened security. Now, that was a policy that was basically abandoned 10 years or so ago, and rightly so, because it was bonkers. Effectively, America was making the entire world security weaker because it felt like it. Now, as we now know with the NSA, GCHQ, and everything that's come out since then, this was obviously part of the wider plan. It's just over time, they could no longer maintain this kind of guise that they were doing it to protect American interests, because actually, America was doing business all over the world, and it was having to do business with computer systems that were inherently flawed. Even the US weren't stupid enough to carry on that particular policy long term. But this new attack effectively allows that very old piece of encryption software that still is floating around on servers and devices all over the world to effectively come back as an avenue of attack. Now, unfortunately, at around 1/3 of all the websites in the world can be tricked into accepting this compromised security schema. Now, what we have to do is we need to patch up the devices that need to talk to those servers. Patching the servers is all well and good up to a point, but there will still be some devices out there that need to use and can only use the older RSA scheme. But obviously, if you've got a modern device, we really don't want any opportunity whatsoever for an attacker to be able to force devices to communicate over that insecure channel. For Apple, that's going to be a nice simple one. They're just going to have to release a software update and push it down to their devices. For Google, well, God knows. The Nexus range will obviously get the update at some point. Although, as we're discovering, you know, Google isn't even being particularly fast at getting those updates out. Again, then when we kind of consider that we are still waiting for devices to get the memory leak patch from Android 5.03 available onto devices, I'm still not seeing that on my Nexus Shield, for goodness sake. And that was obviously a key bug that we had in Android operating system. It doesn't exactly bode well that Google is going to be able to fix this security bug and get it out to even the Lollipop devices in a reasonable time frame, because the ecosystem now has become so fragmented, they have no way to push these very important security updates out. Now, I am absolutely positive that there's going to be a whole section of the Android community here that is going to go and drink the Google Kool-Aid and will be massive apologists for Google because of Google's stupidity. And that's actually what we're dealing with here. Google could have thought ahead on this one many times over the last few years that these security issues have occurred, and they haven't done anything about it. Now, the question we have to start asking ourselves is, are we really trusting Google here? And should we be continuing to trust them? Because I'm starting to feel that Google doesn't actually take security all that seriously. If they did, they would have put systems in place to make sure things could be patched quickly and easily. They never did. They still haven't to this day. And we have to ask ourselves, are they really taking our security at heart? I don't think they are anymore. I think effectively they've bundled themselves up at Google now. When you look at the projects they've been releasing and then killing, if you look at what's been happening with Google Plus, within the Android operating system, with the people who are now in charge of these projects, they're spread too thin. Their focus is not actually into delivering the best product, it's into delivering the most money for Google. Now, I love Google's products, I love Google services, but as I've always said here, I will always tell you the truth about the industry. And at the moment, Google is failing us, and we should be demanding better from them. So let me know what you think in the comments. Is this just yet another storm in the teacup? Bearing in mind, we've had many, many storms in this teacup now. It's looking more like a flipping tsunami for Google with all of these security problems. And do we think that Apple did the right thing by maintaining more of a slimmed down product range and controlling that ecosystem, that they're able to avoid the worst of these security problems? All right, from a security problems point of view, the impact is more minor for Apple. Frankly, there's fewer devices out there to worry about. But even so, should we not have expected more from Google, one of the world's biggest and most innovative software companies, that they couldn't come up with a solution to patch security issues as they came up within the operating system? Unfortunately, it appears that we have to wait months or even years, or we may never actually get these security updates. So again, now we have a billion devices, not just half a billion devices, but now a billion devices open to this vulnerability. My advice would simply be, do not use anything on your Android devices to exchange information like credit card details. Don't make those purchases from your Android device over the internet, because right now you cannot guarantee that the server you're going to be connecting to does not have this vulnerability and that you yourself are not being hijacked. It's a massive pity, and it's yet another black mark for Google. Let's hope they're going to do something about this long term.